Hi, welcome to CompTIA Cloud Plus. In this lesson, we will talk about CI/CD pipelines covering the following topics: automation, code integration, code deployment, testing, security, workflow, artifacts, and repositories. Introduction to CI/CD pipelines. CI/CD pipelines are essential for modern software development and enabling efficient and reliable delivery of applications. Here are the key components of CI/CD pipelines. First one is continuous integration. Here, code changes are merged regularly to a shared repo. This practice ensures that the latest changes are always integrated and tested, reducing integration issues and maintaining the code quality. Number two, build and test. Here, the code is built and tested automatically. Automated testing ensures that the new code does not introduce errors or regressions, maintaining the stability of the applications. Number three, continuous deployment. After tests pass, the app is deployed to production. This allows for rapid and reliable deployment of updates to users, minimizing manual intervention and errors. What are the benefits of CI/CD? Implementing CI/CD pipelines brings numerous advantages to the software development process. Here are some of the primary benefits. Number one is faster releases. Changes are released more frequently and reliably. This reduces time to market and allows for a quicker response to user feedback, enhancing customer satisfaction. Number two is higher quality. Automated testing catches issues early. By identifying and fixing bugs before they reach production, the overall quality of the software is significantly improved. Increased visibility. Full transparency into the software lifecycle. This visibility allows all stakeholders to monitor the progress and status of the development process, fostering better communication and collaboration. And fourth is reduced risks. Problems are detected before going to production. Early detection and resolution of issues reduce the likelihood of critical failures in the live environment, ensuring a more stable product. Let's talk about automation in CI/CD. Automation plays a very important role in the CI/CD process, covering various aspects of software development and deployment. Here are the main areas of automation. First is testing. Automated unit integration and end-to-end tests. Tools like Selenium, JUnit, and PyTests ensure comprehensive testing coverage and catching issues at different stages of the development cycle. Next is deployment. Automated app and infrastructure provisioning. Tools such as Kubernetes, Ansible, and Terraform streamline the deployment process and ensuring consistent and efficient provisioning of resources. Fourth is monitoring. Automated monitoring of app performance. Tools like Prometheus, Grafana, and Datadog provide real-time insights into application health, enabling proactive issue detection and resolution. Effective code integration is fundamental to a smooth CI/CD process. Let's look at the steps involved in code integration. First is the developer push. Here, the developers commit code changes to a shared repo. This ensures that the latest code changes are available to all team members, facilitating collaboration and integration. Next is automation build. Here, code is automatically built and packaged. This step verifies that the code can be compiled and packaged correctly, forming the basis for further testing. Third is testing. It's about unit integration and other tests are run. Automated tests validate the functionality of the code, ensuring that changes do not introduce new issues. And fourth is review and merge. Here, the changes are reviewed and merged to the main branch. Code reviews enhance quality by allowing peers to catch potential issues and improve code standards. Let's talk about code deployment. So deploying code efficiently and reliably is very important for maintaining application performance and availability. Here are the key stages of code deployment. First is continuous delivery. Here, changes are deployed to a staging environment. This intermediate step allows for further testing and validation before changes go live. Next is production deploy. Here, after the review, changes go live to production. This step ensures that only thoroughly tested and approved changes are released to end users and thereby minimizing the risk of failures. Third is rollback. So failed deployments can be quickly reverted because of rollback. This capability provides a safety net, allowing teams to quickly restore a previous stable state if something goes wrong. Let's talk about the build process. The build process transforms source code into a deployment or deployable format. Let's break down the key steps involved. First is checkout. Here, the code is retrieved from the repo. This ensures that the build process uses the latest version of the code base. Then you have compile. Here, source code is compiled into an executable. This step converts the human-readable code into a format that can be run by machines. Next is package. It's all about app files that are packaged into archives. Packaging organizes the compiled code and resources into a distributable format. And for this archive, it's about package artifacts, right, which are being archived. Archiving ensures that the record of each build is kept, enabling traceability and version control. Testing and CI/CD. Testing, again, is a critical component of the CI/CD pipeline, ensuring that the software meets the quality standards. Here are the main types of tests involved. First is unit tests. Tests are isolated units of code. These tests focus on the individual components and verifying their correctness in isolation. Next is integration test, which is about how to test how modules integrate. Integration tests check the interactions between different components, ensuring they work together as expected. And you have the end-to-end tests, where you test the full workflow. These tests simulate the real-world user scenarios, validating the complete functionality of the application. Let's talk about the security in CI/CD. Security must be integrated into every stage of the CI/CD pipeline. Here are the key security practices. Number one is code scanning. Static and dynamic scans find the vulnerabilities. These scans analyze the code for potential security issues, helping to identify and fix vulnerabilities early. Then you have the image scanning, where the container images are scanned for security issues. And this ensures that the containers used in deployment are secure and free from known vulnerabilities. Then you have the secrets management. It's all about the secure management of credentials and keys. So proper secret management protects sensitive information, ensuring that it is only accessible to authorized components and users. CI/CD workflows. The CI/CD workflows define the steps and processes involved in the continuous integration and delivery of software. Here is a typical CI/CD workflow. First is commit code, where the developer's push code changes. This action triggers the CI/CD pipeline and initiating the build and test process. Then you have the run test. The unit integration and end-to-end tests are executed. Automated tests validate the changes, ensuring they meet the quality standards. Then you have the build and package. Here, the application is compiled and packaged. This step prepares the code for deployment by creating distributable artifacts. And next is deploy. Here, the package is deployed to staging or production environment. This ensures that the changes are made available to users or further tested in a staging environment. Then you have monitor. Application performance is being monitored in here. So continuous monitoring provides insights into the health and performance of the applications, enabling prompt issue detection and resolution. So what are artifacts in the CI/CD? Artifacts are the output of the build process and are essential for deployment and distribution. Here are the different types of artifacts. First are images, like virtual machine or container images. And these images encapsulate the application and its dependencies, making deployment consistent and reproducible. Next is packages. The software packages like RPM, right? You have dev, DB, and zip, right? And these packages contain the compiled application and resources ready for installation. And the third one is flat files. It refers to configuration files, scripts, and assets. These files provide necessary configurations, executable scripts, and other resources required by the application. So images are as artifacts. So images are a common type of artifact used in modern software development. And here are the two main types of images. First is our virtual machines. It refers to the full operating system package. Examples include VMware and VirtualBox, which provide complete OS environments for running application. And you have the containers, which are lightweight and portable, portable runtime. Examples include Docker and Kubernetes, which offer efficient and scalable environments for deploying applications. Let's talk about the managing container images. Managing container images involves several key steps to ensure they are built, stored, and deployed correctly. Here are the main steps. First is build image. It refers to the code and dependencies that are built into the image. And this step ensures that the container includes everything needed to run the application. Then you have the push image, where the image is pushed to a container registry. And this makes the image available for deployment and sharing. And you have the deploy image. So the image is deployed on orchestration platform. And this step involves running the container on platforms like Kubernetes. Then you have the run container. It refers to a container instance which is started from the image. This executes the application in the containerized environment, ensuring consistent behavior across different environments. Packages as artifacts. Packages are another type of artifact used for distributing software. Here are the common types of packages. First is RPM package. It is used on Red Hat-based Linux distribution. RPM packages provide a standard way to distribute and install software on Red Hat systems. Then you have the dev packages, DB, used on Debian-based Linux distribution. Dev packages are similar to RPM packages, but are designed for Debian systems, including Ubuntu. Then you have the zip and tar archives, which are cross-platform compressed file archives. These archives can be used on many operating systems, providing a flexible way to distribute software and resources. Let's talk about managing packages. It involves building, storing, deploying, and installing them in a target environment. Here are the key steps. First, build package, where the application is compiled into a package. And this step creates the distributable software package. Then you have the storage package. The package is pushed to an artifact repository, and this ensures that the package is versioned and accessible for deployment. And you have deploy package. The package is deployed to the target environment, and this step makes software available for use. And last is install package. Here, the package is installed on servers or containers, and this ensures that the application is correctly set up and ready to run. Flat files as artifacts. Flat files are essential components that include the configuration files, scripts, and other resources. Here are the main different types of flat files. First is config files. It refers to the app or system configuration file. The app include .properties and .yaml files, which store settings and configuration. You have the scripts. It's all about executable scripts. Examples include bash and Python scripts, which automate tasks and processes. Then you have the assets. It refers to media and data files. Examples include images and JSON files, which provide additional resources needed by the application. Let's talk about the artifact repositories. Artifact repositories are used to store and manage different types of artifacts. And here are the main types of repository. First are code repos. refers to the source code. Like for example, in GitHub, this repositories store the source code and manage the version control. Then you have the container registries for Docker. It is used for Docker and OCI images. These registries are store container images, making them available for deployment. Then you have the artifact repos, like for packages, example Artifactory. These repositories store software packages, managing their versions and dependencies. Right? And the last one is versioning. So versioning is about managing the artifact version. Version control ensures that the correct version of the artifacts are used and tracked throughout the development lifecycle. So in terms of visibility, so for public, it's actually with open visibility. And these repositories allow anyone to view and contribute, promoting open source collaboration and community involvement. When it's private, it will have restricted visibility, and these repositories are accessible only to authorized users, providing better control and security for proprietary code. Then you have collaboration, about open source versus internal team. So public repos support open source projects, while private repos are used for internal development. Then you have the control, community versus the organization. Public repos are maintained by the community, while private repos are managed by the organizations. And lastly, is the cost, free versus paid. So public repositories are generally free, while private repositories often come with a cost, offering additional features and security. All right, that's the end of the lesson. Here we spoke about the CI/CD pipelines, covering the following topics such as automation, code integration and deployment, testing, security, workflow, artifacts, and repositories. Right? Thank you very much for watching the video.